that's built into your brain says, be nice to everyone you meet. Mm-hmm. And that works in nature because everyone you meet is going to be part of the small group. Similarly, everyone you meet is actually probably going to be a cousin. So when I see another human being in distress, weeping or something like that, I have an almost uncontrollable urge to go and console, to maybe, you know, put my arm around them. What's the matter? How can I help? Please let me help you. And that's a strong inner urge, which as a Darwinian, I believe has ancestral roots in a past when I lived in small groups like this, small bands, in which I was likely to be surrounded by kin or surrounded by individuals who could reciprocate. I no longer am. This person who is weeping is a complete stranger to me. They will never reciprocate. And yet the lust is still there. I can't help it.
Oh, she lost it.
She got it last time.
I got another one. Keep her.
Oh, brilliant.
Why are humans often so good to complete strangers? Could it be because our selfish genes are, in some sense, a blessed sense, misfiring? Compare it to sexual desire. The lust to copulate, even though we deliberately use contraception to thwart its evolutionary purpose, is still there because of hard wiring from the genes. Similarly, we have a lust to be nice, even to total strangers, because niceness has been hardwired into us from the time when we used to live in small groups of close kin and close acquaintances with whom it would pay to reciprocate favors. This, for me, is the antidote to the darkness some have seen in our Darwinian heritage. And it goes further. The joy of being conscious human beings is that we rise above our origins. Our misfiring selfish genes mean we don't ape the nastiness of nature, but extract ourselves from it and live by our values. As Darwin recognized, we humans are the first and only species able to escape the brutal force that created us, natural selection. We civilized men do our utmost to check the process of elimination. We build asylums for the imbecile, the maimed, and the sick. We institute poor laws, and our medical men exert their utmost skill to save the life of every one to the last moment. This is the 999 Club in London's East End. It takes in the less fortunate, alcoholics, drug addicts, and the homeless, providing them with tea and hot meals. Such altruism is, I believe, among the pinnacles of human civilization. We care for the most vulnerable in our society. We look after the sick. We give welfare to the needy.
Because I feel, which I've always felt, that they need something hot to warm them up. You know, when they've been out all night sleeping and they've got no warmth in their bodies, now you think, if we only have a cup of soup.
And what makes you feel the need to be so nice and so good?
Well, I was a war child, so we never had a lot of food, and that's why I've always try to look after these best I can, you know, and I think, well, if they're hungry, I'll feed them.
So you felt hungry as a child, so
yes.
You felt, I don't want that to happen to other people.
No, that's it. That's yes. How I felt.
We can empathise. We can imagine how it is for others. A society run on crude Darwinian lines would be a ruthless, merciless place. Fortunately, natural selection gave us big brains. With those big brains, we can plan a gentler society, the sort of society in which we would want to live. Evolution has no purpose. There's no benevolence there, no forward planning. Some people find that disturbing, but there is a better way to think about it. We, alone on Earth, have evolved to the extraordinary point where we can understand the selfish genes that shaped us. They are not models for how to behave, but the opposite.
Because we are conscious of these forces, we can work towards taming them. Through kindness and morality, modern medicine, charity, even paying our taxes, we can overthrow the tyranny of natural selection. Our evolved brains empower us to rebel against our selfish genes.
Next time, Into the Lion's Den, today's religious backlash against Darwin. The ever more elaborate strategies to deny the evidence of evolution, and how Darwin himself struggled with the implications of his own theory.